Okay, these are our points to consider for migration. And magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Ito ang inyong kabisang Cris Aranda. Ito ang inyong kabisang Cris Aranda. Ayan. Okay. Ito po ang ating ano. Ayan. Ating Amerika at iba pa.
Kapalaran abroad, gusto bang subukan sa Australia, UK, Canada, New Zealand? May diploma ka ba o experience lamang? Huwag ka mag-alala, kaya kang tulungan dito lamang sa Amerika at iba pa. Visa mo sagot ko sa tuwing Sabado. Sabado ang araw, manood ka dito. Amerika't iba pa para sa visa mo.
Okay, yan po yung ating Amerika't iba pa. Topic natin ngayon ay points for migration. Okay, points for migration. Yan po yung ating topic. Points to consider for migration. Alright. Ano ba yan? For 2021, for next year, kasi matatapos na tayo eh, magpapasko na. New year na yan, susunod. So, for 2021, it will be the year for application. Yes. Because next year, dapat nakapaghanda na kayo and you should be submitting your application for permanent residency as a skilled worker, whether it's Australia, Canada, New Zealand, UK. Ang US kasi hindi sa point system. Okay, so 2022 is what? What year is 2022? Application. Why application? Because when you submit your application, you can update. You can improve your score so that if you have better English scores, or maybe you're already in Canada or Australia and you have studied in those countries, then you will be able to get more scores because you have your completion of studies. And if you got a job offer, our dogs are barking again because they can hear my voice. So 2022 is application, and 2023 is when you can be selected for immigrant residency. Yan. Yan po yung points to consider for migration. Now, ano yung epekto ng COVID-19 sa mga visa application? Ayun, nagtatago. Siya ay shadow ng COVID-19. You cannot come to Australia, for example, unless you are in an exempt category. You have been granted an individual exemption to the current travel restrictions, and you must also have a valid visa. Then, ano yung processing priority ng Australia? Processing priority dun sa mga travelers in the exempt categories to support urgent travel. Applicants are encouraged to apply online whenever possible for faster processing, because online is faster than when you lodge by paper. Mas mura pa. And the electronic travel authority is under trial or being trialed. But the Philippines is not an ETA eligible country. And Australia is also warning about disruption of services. Medical examination by overseas panel doctors in the Philippines, English language testing facilities and biometric collection centers sa visa center ng dito sa BFS Global. Yung mga doctors, maaaring hindi sila nagbibigay ng medical exam, so merong disruption of services. However, you will be given additional time to complete and check your checks and provide the requested information. So, in a COVID effect sa Australia. So, Australia, if you want to apply as a permanent resident in Australia, you need 65 points to qualify for a skilled visa category, especially subclass 189, skilled independent ETIAN. Points criteria. If you are between 33 to 39, then you get 25 points. Hindi kasama yung malakas ang tahol ng aso mo. Walang points yun. But if your English is at least 7, you get 10 points. If you get 8 scores, 8 in each component, you get 20 points. Pero ang ating example, 10 points lang. If your experience is 5 years of experience in the last 8 years, you get 10 points. Education, if you have a bachelor's degree, you get 15 points. So, ang total mo, 65 ka na. So, you may be eligible to apply sa Australia. However, dun sa nakaraang invitation nila, ang nabigyan lang, while 65 ang score, ito ay mga applicants na nasa Australia, not outside Australia. So, if you're outside Australia and you're only getting 65 points, maaaring hindi ka mag-qualify. Hanggang tahol ka na lang. Your bark is worse than your bite. Okay. So, yan po yung Australia. So, kung gusto mong ma-improve ang score mo, if you're overseas, then improve your English. Instead of 7, you get 20. If your score is IELTS 8. And if you're in Australia, you studied in Australia, get 5 points. And if you get nominated by a state or territory, you get 5 points. Therefore, your total can be 80. But that is if you're in Australia. Right now, if you're in Australia, if you only have 65 points, you may qualify. Ito yung profile ng qualified applicants sa Australia. Skilled independent, as of April, 95 ang score. Ang naimbitahan is only 50. Yung skilled regional family is 491. 95 ang score. Ang naimbitahan is 50. Dun sa skilled independent, as of September 11, because meron silang invitation round every month, the score has gone down from 65 para sa skilled independent and 75 for the skilled regional family. Ang naimbitahan is 350 sa skilled independent, and sa regional family in who lives in a designated area is 150 ang naimbitahan. Para sa skilled independent, as of October 21, the last time na nagkaroon ng selection, invitation round ng Australia, wala pa silang selection sa November. So, skilled independent, 65 ang score, as I mentioned kanina, parehong 65 ang score, but that's if you are in Australia. And only 30 were invited sa skilled independent, and dun sa skilled regional family, 491, 80 ang naimbitahan. Yan ang sa Australia. At yung buong for the 2021 program, July 2020 to June 2021, ang total is para sa skilled independent is 990. Sa 491, ito ay 420. So ito yung sa Australia. Sa Canada, for current and future PR applicants sa express entry. For current applications, permanent resident applications are not processing normally because of the COVID. Binanggit natin kanina anong effect ng COVID dun sa applications sa Canada. So even in Canada, permanent residence applications are not processing normally, but they still accepting. Okay, hindi lang nagpo-process ng normal under normal conditions. And the time to submit missing documents ay dinagdagan. So bilang consideration because of COVID, if you will not be able to make it, then the time to submit your missing documents had been extended from up to 90 days from the deadline. And applications in progress will not be closed or refused. So yun yung isa naman benefit ng COVID sa mga current applicants, current applications. And language testing organizations have resumed scheduling of exams. So pwede na kumuha ng IELTS or any other English exam. How about sa future applicants, future applications? Most permanent resident applications are still being accepted, katulad ng sinabi natin kanina. While those who already have permanent residence applications is not being processed normally, but you can still submit your application. Hindi humihinto ang pagtanggap. Although review and processing have been affected by COVID-19, and there is no estimate on any processing times. But the sooner you submit your application, the better it is. So anong sabi natin kanina? 2021 is the year for application. 2022 is application para ma-improve ang yung scores. And 2023 is when you can be invited to apply sa Canada. Because they will select based on the profile mo sa dun sa express entry candidates. So, future applications. They are focusing on priority applications. Canadians and permanent residents who are returning to the country, inuuna nila ito, yung mga babalik ng Canada. And vulnerable groups. Work permits for people who perform or support essential services. Yan. Yan ang sa Canada, ang epekto ng COVID. Ano yung priority occupations for work and permanent residency? Sa Australia, 11 of the 18 priority occupations are for registered nurses and healthcare workers. Ito'y para dun sa Priority Migration Skilled Occupations List or PMSOL. Yan yung sa Australia, yung priority nila. Sa Canada, meron silang kinakatakutan, yung third wave, shortage ng healthcare workers who are too exhausted, too burnt out, or have fallen ill with COVID themselves due to the second wave of coronavirus. So yung second wave, naka-apekto, magkakaroon ng third wave. Pero yung third wave is not because of the COVID. It's not COVID, but still COVID-related. The third wave is crisis in shortage of healthcare workers. Sa New Zealand, priority for people with occupational registration and those earning twice the median wage. Tinaasan nila yung minimum income na kailangan o median wage. Kailangan ngayon ang minimum na salary mo is $51 an hour. Oh my goodness, mga OFWs. $51 per hour. If you're an OFW, pwede ka sa New Zealand kung ikaw ay nasa priority list nila. But kita mo yung kinikita, $51 an hour. And New Zealand dollars of 106,080 a year. Yun ang pwede mong kitain sa New Zealand. Huh? Wow. But that's if you'll be able to get to New Zealand. So, sa UK, sa baba, sa UK, health and social workers, education and childcare. These are the priority occupations sa UK. Sa US, frontline healthcare workers, workers in the food, restaurant, aviation and utility industries, shortage of traveling nurses reported by the New Yorker. Ayan, yun po yung mga priority occupations in these countries. Alright? Okay. Okay, inayos lang po natin ang ating camera. Taasan natin ng konti. Ayan. Okay, tinaasan ng konti. Focus natin. Alright, so next. Kung kayo sa Canada mag-a-apply and this applicant is overseas, kung kayo nandito, let's say it's 2022, nakapag-prepare na kayo, so pwede ngayon pa lang makita nyo na kung ano ang potential na score ninyo. If you're single, you are 32 years of age, you are single, you're competent in English, siyempre, andito ka sa Pilipinas, so hindi ka nagsari sa Canada, you have no points, you have no job offer, but your English proficiency will give you 124 points. Your transferability, the combination of English and education, English and work experience is 75. So ang subtotal mo is 335 or 413. Yan ang magiging score mo. Now, if the same applicant is in Canada, siya ay 32 years din, pareho lang, nasa Canada na siya, pareho ng education. Pero yung kanyang English, dahil nasa Canada, gumanda dahil nasa Canada na siya. So, ang kanyang core factors is 350 because nag-aral siya sa Canada, 15 points. Meron siyang job offer, 50 points. English proficiency, Tomas, as you can see, dun sa naandito siya sa Pilipinas, ang score niya is 124. But since nasa Canada siya, tumaas ang English niya, naging 136. And yung transferability, because she can communicate well, she can succeed well in her career, so yung transferability ay naging 75. And subtotal niya is 425, so ang kanyang total ay 490. Ito kung nasa Canada siya, 490. Now, ito ay single na individual. What happens kung siya ay nag-asawa? Nag-asawa siya. He got married. So, kung nasa Canada naman siya, pero 2 years later na siya, no? So 34 na siya. Ang kanyang edad ay 75 points. Bumaba ang kanyang edad. Pero dahil nag-aral siya sa Canada, meron siyang 112 points. Yung kanyang language tumaas 128. Siya ay married na. All right? So ito yung ang kanyang core factors is 315. But yung kanyang spouse factors, merong 35. So ang kanyang magiging overall total kung say nasa Canada after 2 years of studying would be 490. Eh ilan lang yung score ng nakakaraan na inaimbitahan? 465, 470. So 490 should get you going if you're in Canada, even if you're married. Ah, and if you're married, ito yung mag-asawa. Even if you're married, nag-aral siya eh. Okay, so yung si Miss Jane de la Cruz, authorized to work in Canada for 20 hours a week while studying or in school, 40 hours a week kung siya ay wala sa eskwelahan, and she gets 15 points for Canadian studies, 50 points for job offer, and improved language proficiency. Ito yung si Miss Jane. How about si Mr. John? Si Mr. John, yung kanyang spouse or partner, because hindi naman sila kailangan mag-asawa, but kung common law, pwede na rin sila. So, si John. Si John ay authorized to work kung siya ay kasama ni Jane. Pwede siya magtrabaho sa Canada habang nag-aaral si Jane. And full-time work for duration of spouse, habang nag-aaral si Jane, siya ay full-time na nagtatrabaho. And then bonus points kung makakompleto siya ng 1 year work and qualify under the Canadian Experience Class. Kasi dun sa Express Entry, ang selection ng applicant sa Canada, meron dun sa Express Entry, they select the program. It's either you qualify under the Federal Skilled Worker Class or you qualify under the Canadian Experience Class or you qualify under the Provincial Nomination Program. So ito, si John, dahil siya ay nakapagtrabaho sa Canada ng 1 year, pwede siya mag-qualify sa Canadian Experience Class other than just the FSWP. So yun yung mga bonus if you study in Canada, if you're in Canada, and if you got a spouse also proficient in English, nagtrabaho doon, yun ang kagandahan sa Canada as opposed to Australia or New Zealand. Sa Canada, if you got a spouse or common law partner, your spouse or partner can work 40 hours a week, ha? Full-time, can work full-time. Yun ang kagandahan sa Canada. So, balikan natin. Sundan natin. Ayan, both can work full-time up to 3 years because meron postgraduate work permit si Jane. And during that another 3 years, pwede pa rin magtrabaho si John. So, John and Jane can work another 3 years full-time sa Canada. Ang Brexit naman, after Brexit, sinabi ni Priti Patel from January 2021, skilled workers would have to be sponsored by approved UK employers. Ang minimum skill level ay RQF3, English proficient, and the salary threshold must be £25,000 a year. Ito yung minimum na dapat pasweldohin sa'yo. For skilled workers with salary of 20,490, hindi umabot ng 425, you may still apply by earning additional points. For example, if your job is in a shortage occupation or you need a PhD for the job that's being offered to you. So, meron din silang bagong graduate immigration route for international students na nakakomplete ng degree sa UK from summer of 2021. You'll be able to work or look for work in the UK for any skill level for up to 2 years. And yung seasonal agricultural visa pilot program will be expanded and no immigration route for lower skilled workers. Yan, sa UK. And eto pa, sa global talent scheme, top scientists and researchers to be given fast track entry to the UK under Tier 1. In lieu of Tier 1. Wala na kasi yung Tier 1 eh. So meron silang Global Talent Scheme. Yung sa UK. How do you get the points sa UK? Minimum is 70 points. So ito yung basic. You must have a job offer. Kasi sa UK, in the UK, walang direct application sa migration. You must be working for at least 5 years before you can be eligible for skilled migration or settlement na tinatawag. Kung ikaw ay naka 5 years, hindi ka naka 5 years, sandali lang po. Kung ikaw ay hindi naka 5 years, you will not be able to apply because you need the 5 years minimum para ka mag-qualify. So, ang iyong points would be you need a job offer. So, as yung assumption dito, meron ka pang job offer. So, you have 20 points. And your job is, yung skill level mo for the job is appropriate. So, you get 20 points. Your English is good because you can work on the job. So, you get 50 points. But you need 70 points, right? Oh, balikan natin. You need 70 points. So, meron kang 20 sa job offer. Meron kang 20 because your skill is... The skill needed for the job is you have it and you can speak English or communicate well, so you get 50 points. How do you get the other 20 points? Yung salary. Sa salary. If your salary is only 23,040 to 25,599, you get 10 points. So 10 pa lang yan. So dapat ang sweldo mo mas mataas sa 25,599, hindi ba? So, you get 20 points if your salary is 25,600 pounds a year or above. And you get 20 points if your occupation is in short supply. So, kung naghahanap ka ng trabaho, ang dapat mong tingnan, meron kang minimum na 50 points, yung job offer, skill level, and English. At para makakuha ka ng 20 points, your job must be in a shortage occupation or your salary is above 25,600 or above. For the education, eto yan, tingnan natin. Okay. Ano yung shortage occupation sa UK? Bago tayo pumunta sa education. Biological scientist, biochemist, ayan, IT, engineers, and nurses, including kasama na dyan ang secondary education and teaching professionals, architects, quantity surveyors, social workers, at ito, nababasa ninyo. So, education. You get 10 points if a PhD is related to the job. Therefore, kung ikaw ay ordinaryong OFW, wala kang PhD, kailangan mo na ang offer sa iyong trabaho is 25,600 or above, or your occupation fee in short supply. Ang mga nurses ay in short supply. Shortage sila ngayon eh. Okay, yan yan sa UK. And these are the factors, pagkumparahin natin. Sa Australia, if you're applying from overseas, kailangan mo ng 95. Sa New Zealand, you need 160 points. Sa Canada, it varies from 452 to 465. Ngayon ay tumataas, naging 470. But ito yung average. So, Australia muna tayo. So, if you're between 25 to 32, you get 30 points. If your English is good, proficient ka sa English, 8 ang score mo sa IELTS, you get 20 points. Experience mo is 3 to 4 years, 10 points. You have a bachelor's degree, 15. You're nominated by state or territory. And you have a job offer. So, ang total mo would be, follow the arrow, 95, yung yellow. So, yun mang kailangan mo sa Australia. Sa New Zealand, ang age mo, the same age, kung mag-a-apply ka sa New Zealand, you get 30 points as well. But even if you have good English, wala kang points sa good English, but it is a requirement. If your experience is not recognized because dapat comparable ang work, comparable labor market, ang Philippines, hindi daw comparable labor market, tulad sabi ng New Zealand. So, even if you have experience in the Philippines, it will not be recognized sa New Zealand. So, wala kang points kung hindi ka nagtrabaho sa New Zealand. Now, kung ikaw ay nagtrabaho sa New Zealand, then pwede yan. Tingnan natin. Iwanan muna natin yan. Okay? And pumunta tayo sa New Zealand. Ito yung New Zealand. Ito yung kanilang how you get the points sa New Zealand. Ayan, oh, nakikita ninyo? So, you need minimum 100 points. Ito ay, let's say, you are between 20 and 39, you get 30 points. Ito yan, 30 points. So, you get 30 points for age. So, you get 30 points for age. Ayun sa New Zealand, 30 points for age. And then, you have a job offer, you know, 50 points. So, you get 50 points. And your occupation is in the long-term skill shortage list. Then you get an absolute skill shortage. You get 10 points. Then, if your education is, if you got a bachelor's degree and it's declared as the same as a New Zealand qualification, you get 50 points, level 7 or 8. And lastly, would be wala kang work experience kasi nga hindi recognized ang labor market ng Pilipinas. So you only get what? You only get 140 points. Kulang ka. Kailangan ay 160 sa New Zealand. Balikan natin ang ating presentation. So let's go back to our presentation. Mm-hmm. Nasa New Zealand tayo kanina. So, balikan natin from current slide. Ito yung sa UK. Balikan natin itong UK. Let's go to New Zealand dito sa ating comparison na. Ayan. So, let's go to this. So, slide show natin sa current slide. Ayan. So, you need 160. But remember, when we computed it. So, hindi umabot. Sa New Zealand, 140 lang. Kung sa Canada naman, the same age, you get 88 points. The same English proficiency, you get 124. And your experience is 50. If you got a job offer, you get either 50 or 200. Then your points total would be 407. But you need 452 to 465. And lately, naging 471. So, how do you up skill? Paano mo maitataas ang score mo? After submitting your application, how can you up your application? So, ito. You can either study in Canada, improve your English. So, even if you're not in Canada, imbis na magbabayad ka ng tuition fee, siguro gandaan mo yung score mo sa English. So, kumuha ka ng IELTS, mag-review ko sa IELTS. So, improve your English proficiency. And i-search mo, meron ka bang kamag-anak, let's say, sa Manitoba. Kung meron kang kamag-anak sa Manitoba, you'll be able to apply directly sa Manitoba because in Manitoba, you get points kung ikaw ay merong strong connection sa Manitoba. But it's only in Manitoba. Then you can also check in other provinces, for example, in Alberta, British Columbia, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia. Tumingin ka, saan bang mga provinces sa Canada meron kang either ka-eskwela mo, kamag-anak mo na na-check mo sa Facebook, oy, may kamag-anak pala ako sa Alberta, may kamag-anak pala ako sa Ontario. So, you can check with them because maybe even if hindi sila pwedeng magbigay ng trabaho sa'yo, they know somebody who can offer a job. So, meron kang referral. So, it's good to have community and family-based or friends doon sa mga bansa na yan, especially in provinces sa Canada, because they can help you up your application. Application para tumaas. So, 2021 is the year to submit your application and now you can prepare. And 2021 is you prepare and submit your application. And then 22 is application. 2023, probability na ikaw ay ma-invite to apply. Then selection bilang immigrant sa Canada, Australia, or New Zealand. So, yun po yung ating balikan lang natin. Balikan natin yung what the year would be. Let's go. Dito po. Balikan natin siya sa unang-una. Sa ito yan. Points to consider. Para alam natin. If you want to apply December tayo ngayon eh. So January na next year. So next year would be 2021. And 2021 should be the year to apply. Submit your application. Prepare and submit your application so that you'll be considered as one of the candidates sa Canada Express Entry, sa Australia Skill Select, sa New Zealand ay Expression of Interest. So 2022, you apply, you upskill, so application. And 2023, because of that, na-upsize ka, na-update mo, 2023 would be the selection para sa iyong, ikaw ay mabigyan ng visa bilang permanent resident dun sa mga bansa na yun. Okay? So, I hope that we were able to give you how it is to upskill, to improve your chances of being a skilled migrant sa Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and UK. Because kung sa US ang pag-uusapan, dalawa lamang sa US eh. It's either you have a family member, and the family member is either a US citizen or permanent resident, or you have an employer who will be sponsoring as an immigrant under the EB3 category. Ito yung employment-based third preference category. A skilled worker or professional, mga nurses, skilled and other skilled workers. So, yun yung ating topic ngayon. And I hope that you were able to learn something. Hanggang sa susunod nating pagkikita, that will be next week. Until then, have a good weekend, safe and distance weekend. And be sure that you not only have a safe distance, you also have your mask. Okay, mga kababayan? Hasta la visa, mga kabisa.